Sometimes it's hard to know exactly how we are to share. Good morning. On behalf of the Ainga of ELISE FUATIA TOGIA, I would like to share my expression of gratitude to each and every one of you for being here today to celebrate and share the life of my city's hardworking father, ELISE FUATIA TOGIA. I also want to thank everyone who had donated to the cause of my father's funeral service. I want to thank all my family members and friends who came over to help during our final beloved. Me and my siblings are grateful. For those who do not know me, my name is ELISE TOGIA Jr. I am the oldest child out of three brothers, Paul Mose TOGIA and Aitofele TOGIA. My two sisters, Arietta Mary TOGIA and Amanda Yalua. Mose can't be here with us today, but I am honored to be here to speak on behalf of me and my brother, Paul Mose TOGIA, to you about my dear father. Each of you here had your own relationship with my father. His brothers, his sisters, nephew, nieces, cousins, uncles, aunties, friends, and our house dog, Princess. Each of you has your own set of memories and your own word picture that describe this man laying here today. I don't presume to know the man that you knew, but I hope today in this testimony that I offer, you will recognize some part of the man that we all knew, the man that is no longer among us, the man who will never be gone until all of us here have come to pass. Listening to people speak about how my father impacted their lives and the deep personal connection that people felt with my father has been an overwhelming emotional experience. Losing my father is one of the most difficult things I have gone through. As I am standing up here today, I realize how fortunate I was to have ELISE FUATIA TOGIA as my father. There are not words to express his influence in all of our lives. It is through his example that I will expand as an individual in this dying world. I thought about my father every single day. My wonders had turned into evaluation and trying to understand my 29 years I spent with this man. I tried to evaluate his example and live by his example. You see, as a child, we usually don't hear what our parents speak of, but we do duplicate their actions. My father was a strong man, tall, deep voice, but gentle, very loving, yet he was a simple man. Most importantly, my father made sure we were taken care of. However, he was no saint by any means stretch of imagination. My father was never, in my experience, an overly religious man. Although there were a number of times in his life he preferred to Jesus. When my father was in a situation, he always fell back on the core values that he had learned and tried to impress on his children the importance of doing the right thing. My father didn't read books about child care. He relied on common sense values, live honestly, work efficiently, make the most of every moment, cherish what you have, find a way to make others smile and find things that make you smile, contribute to the world, and make time to enjoy your contributions. The day my mother had come to pass, we arrived home from the hospital. My father went straight to the kitchen, cleaned the dishes, as mothers would do. I recommend my father to let me take over, and so he did. As I washed his dishes, my mind triggered the memories of my mother's movements and responsibilities through the years in this house at Bohill Park Terrace, 1564 C, Liverpool Street. My father would clean the kitchen on a regular day basis, wash dishes, cook, anything a mother would do. I believe these chores brought him closer to my mother, Maria, as it did for me too. Every Sunday, he would cook up his steak, or his famous baked sweet shoyu chicken, and his favorite baked shrimp with mayo, preparing for NFL Sunday football. I sat one afternoon and watched my father mow the yard, enjoying himself under the sun, like literally. He would not let no one cut his grass but himself. And then he would walk to the fence and hand the mow over to his brother, Paul Tongyeo, who lives on the other side of the fence. He loved working the yard, pulling out grass roots. He never stopped recycling, never stopped watching the news. He would get annoyed seeing dishes in the sink. So one day, all the dirty dishes in the sink, he took it all and threw it in the trash. I thought that was hilarious. My father was one, he was an alcoholic and a smoker. But quitting both was one of the best accomplishments, and I'm proud of him. Mind over matter. After quitting smoking and drinking, I seen a difference in him in his life. He spent more time with his children, had time to make sure our home wasn't crummy. He smiled more, did more things, doubled his warm greetings, and talked to more single girls. My father was an alcoholic, but he never laid his hands on his children. Never. He had my sober mother to do that. My father had patience with his children. My father's patience wasn't developed over of just loving his children. It was developed by understanding the commencement of a child, the beginning of getting life of a child. My father, the oldest son, helped raise his brothers and sisters. So he was sort of an experience when he had children. They held the same concept. My mother was the emotional one and my father was rational. My father's life with my mother set a glowing example of a kind of beautiful, unconditional love required for a successful marriage. My father was hardworking, strong, loving, and gentle, loved his family, and was deeply devoted to my mother and his children. My father provided for us an example of the strength of a man who truly loves his wife. My father's example to us was that a man could strive to have a relationship with a woman based on love and mutual respect and understanding. That kept the balance in our team. I recall the first time he shed tears. It was really rare to see my father shed tears. And the only time I see my father shed tears was at the airport, departing while his brothers and sisters departed from the airport. He will shed tears like someone had passed. Every morning at 6 a.m., Monday to Saturday, I would awake to loud morning news and aroma of the coffee. See, my father always watched the news. My father had a deep passion for justice. So many times when he saw injustice on the news, he would get sincerely upset. That passion for problems of the world is something that I like to think he passed on to me. Sometimes we agreed on politics and sometimes we disagreed. but we always respected each other's opinions. I never had these observations while living here in Hawaii. It is bitter to, it took me to be away from home for 5 years to be aware of his behavior. I thought about my father every day. While in Florida, I would empty out all these cigarette butts out of my pocket into the trash. And my friends many times would ask, "Elise, what in the world are you doing with all these cigarette butts in your pocket?" Numerous times, the same question would be asked over and over. Over time, I pulled out cigarette butts from my pocket, and I would be so proud to tell them why I have all these cigarette butts in my pocket. Me and my friends, we used to chill in front of the crib and smoke cigarettes and flick our cigarette butts all over the yard. One morning, I would get up and see my father picking up these butts from the yard. From there on, I never flicked a cigarette butt in my yard. Putting a cigarette butt into a trash is such an easy task, but so hard. Quote, "You got to think about big things while you're doing small things, so that all the small things go into the right direction." Alvin Toffler. From the village of Honolulu, American Samoa, where he met my mother, Kalala Malia Aitofeli Tumia, giving birth to me, my brother Mose, and my twin sisters, Ariette and deceased twin sister Rose. My father did one of the most amazing things. I feel it was right in his time. I could never take the thought of this event out of my head. He got his family on a plane and went airborne to Hawaii. He left home, he left the nest, he left his childhood memories back. You see, back in the days, our people of Polynesia navigate the great Pacific seas, day and night using the stars in the heavens for guidance. Our people had no idea what was out there in the deep blue ocean and beyond. Because there wasn't such thing as maps back in the days in that time of period. Stories and guidance was passed down through different generations by word of mouth. A lot of people have been lost in the great Pacific seas. Our people, the navigators, accepted the fact death was a possibility without turning back while traveling the Pacific seas. The Polynesians took the leap of faith. It took the time to understand the stars and the heavens. Our intentions and commitment grow stronger when we have very important reasons to follow a vision. This curiosity of our people was built out of a purpose. Purpose. What is purpose? Purpose is like math. You got an equation, a problem, or a complication, an obstacle, an intriguing dispute that brings out the determination to find a resolution. An answer. My father's purpose coming to America was every father's purpose migrating to America. A chance for his family to exceed of what he was capable of. A chance. It took him the courage and calculation to navigate to different environments. I will honor him by carrying the same courage and navigating to the unknown. My father was not, my father was no superhero, nor a knight that swings a sword fighting dragons, but he was a fisherman. As children, we think fishermen like, nobody cares about a fisherman until they start starving. Whenever tragic loss occurs, you either resist or you yield. Some people become bitter or deeply resentful. Others become compassionate, wise, and loving. My father left. He lived an example. I watched him. As a child, I was blinded, but I seen. It took me some time to step back and evaluate and follow his behavior. He sat in front of our house, and every time I called Hawaii, everybody would say he's in front of the house. He would roll by and wave. My father would wave back. My father loved Chinatown. My father loved playing cards. My father's favorite soda was a little tea. And my father always wore slippers until today. To the children out there, having fun at a young age, you know, you're gonna come to that point when your father becomes old. And you need to evaluate and observe his movements, his decisions, his actions. Thank you.
Senior is not dead as people of the world know it. He is only asleep.